Grandview Motel. Could survivors be hiding inside?
It's pop.
Hi, Jesse.
Well, I've got a bureau to run. See you soon.
Yes, ma'am, Director Faden.
Please, Emily. Not even as a joke.
There's no way this happened by accident.
When do you think Marshall's coming back? It's not like her to be absent during a crisis.
Marshall's as tough as they come. You don't need to worry about her.
I hope you're right.
Even if it was a dream, I feel Darling reached out to me through the hotline. Problem in the Foundation. That was Ati's vacation spot. We need to check this out.
Dark, quiet, trans-dimensional. This place really suits Ati. So that etching is the door. Okay, let's try opening it. No time for sightseeing. The board said this was an emergency. Looks like no one's been down here in a while. Be having a field day down here.
My life's been a strange one. Certainly stranger than I'd like. But this place, it's something else. The floors crawl, the walls slither, it's a shifting pit. On the street, it's a building standing there for anyone to see. No one does. How do we miss it? Acting Director Northmore now is on a train.
The Foundation. I only heard of the Foundation when I became head of operations. The very bottom of the oldest house. Director access only. Just the name alone is classified. Zachariah gave me a tour the day I was promoted. Said I should see it for myself. To understand. After that, I snuck down on my own from time to time to keep tabs on the place, and on them. But nothing ever changed down there. Not even the walls. It's solid, permanent, different from the rest of the house. Of course, they were always watching me. I never stayed long. I'm not stupid. I have to stop the hiss from finding this place. I'm the only one who can.
bottom of the open hell. Stop the hiss.
Marshall? How was she on the hotline? Unless she's dead. Jesus. She seemed like the kind of woman who could survive anything. Using pickaxes now? astral plane is cutting into our dimension. What if this happens in the upper floors? It'll destroy the Bureau. I'd brought Emily with me. I could really use my head of research right about now.
Marshall? Marshall! Oh no! Wait! It's Jesse! The director! Marshall? Can you hear me?
She was on the hotline, so that person couldn't have been Marshall, right? One problem at a time. Let's see what's going on with that pillar first.
It's been 5 days since we first entered the building.
Okay.
This broken pillar is called the Nail. It was broken by something, and now the astral plane is bleeding into the foundation, which will destroy the oldest house, the bureau, and everyone inside. I need to find four locks, or keys, or whatever, to stop that from happening. But I'm the director. I've handled worse. This should be simple. Ish. You with me?
I've served under two directors. Three now, I suppose. Trench and I worked our way up together. We made it through the tough cases, the bad days, the casualties. He was the epitome of a good agent. Smart, decisive, selfless. Then he picked up that damn gun. Becoming director is a formal process overseen by the board. Lots of ritual and mystery. After that, key staff provide detailed briefs on all classified matters, past and present, but with Faden, well, there's no protocol for field promotion. The girl's smart, has a good head on her shoulders. I'm trusting her to handle the hiss upstairs, while I hold them off here. All this shit with the Nail, the board, I'm not sure she's ready. Besides, I work better alone.
Faden. Not sure she's ready.
I'm here, aren't I? I saved the Bureau once, and I'll do it again.
Worse and worse. That's the case. Looks like the astral bleed goes both ways. Thank you. astral plane? That didn't go so well.
Thank you.
86.
The one I used to get in here. /key the board told me about?
Jesse, hey!
Emily, how did she get down here?
If it isn't my favorite director. Director Faden.
What are you doing down here, Emily? What do you mean? You called me down, remember? I'm pretty sure I didn't. No, that's right. You didn't. But then, I remember you needing me to come here. I mean, you even told me how to get in. Let's just chalk it up to synchronicity so we can get to work.
She takes everything in stride.
The board called me down here to deal with the situation. The astral plane is colliding with our world. I know, isn't it fascinating? I never even considered that the astral plane could be a physical volume expanding beyond its dimensional container. The bleed is localized to this area, but its growth rate seems steady. Given time, it will consume the entire Bureau. And possibly beyond. That's what I'm here to stop. The board told me to fix the nail over there by dismantling 4 locks in the astral plane. Funny, I think it's put itself back together a bit. So that could be due to the law of inverse exchange. For every associated component you remove, this nail reconstructs. Or possibly some variation of anti-sympathy. Don't worry. I'll look into it. Did you notice all the Bureau infrastructure? It looks like there was a research team stationed down here at some point. Do you think Darling knew about this?
I put money on it. That reminds me. Have you seen Marshall? She contacted me over the hotline, but then I saw her walking around.
I haven't seen her. The hotline only connects to extraplanar entities. Or dead people. But Marshall's proved time and time again that she's a survivor.
That's exactly what I thought.
Anyway, I've been looking into the minerals growing down here. Have you noticed how they insist on maintaining a certain form? Maybe some sort of a state memory, or they consciously prefer a certain shape?
I think we're on a clock here, Emily. I need to stop the astral bleeding before it brings the oldest house down. See what you can find out from the nail in the meantime. And send out some rangers to look for Marshall. She may be in trouble.
Will do, Jesse. If you see anything interesting, remember to take detailed notes. The rangers have tapped into an old radio network they found around the Foundation. So if you need backup, just call them at one of the stations.
How did the Hiss get into the Foundation?
Same way we did, I imagine. But you need to remember that the Hiss are the embodiment of persistence. Their nature seems to be one of force, to find every possible vulnerability and exploit it. Their only goal is consumption.
I'm sure there's plenty of goodies for them down here. The Nail, for instance.
If the Hiss could corrupt the Nail, I'm sure they would have by now. It must not interest them in its broken state. They could be distracted by the numerous unknown paranatural materials I'm sure are lying around. These are the roots of the oldest house. The Hiss will find plenty of ways to make trouble.
They're pretty good at that. So you've never heard of the Foundation, huh?
I've never even seen the name referenced. Clearly it's highly classified, but for what reason? The problem with these kinds of closed-off hidden areas is that they were likely sealed for good reason. But now no one is left to tell us what that reason was.
Any guesses why the Bureau would hide something like this?
I only know what I've observed. This place is spatially rigid, which means it doesn't shift like the rest of the oldest house. Before you ask why that is, I have to admit that I'm clueless. There's some signal interfering with my equipment, making it hard to get a clear reading. It's being emitted from the floor. Maybe I should have brought a jackhammer.
The astral plane is already taking chunks out of this place, Emily. Let's not add to it. So let me get this straight. The astral plane is bleeding into the Foundation.
Correct.
And that's happening because the Nail is damaged.
I'd say it's a bit more than damaged, but yes, that is my understanding.
So, what's the connection between the Nail and the astral plane?
It's a good question. See, I always pictured objects of power as strings between our plane and the astral. If the Nail has a similar relationship, then maybe it's more accurate to think of it like plumbing. Now that the Nail is busted, sewage is gushing everywhere.
Not the prettiest metaphor.
I should get back out there.
Agreed. The astral bleed won't stop itself.